Years ago, guano miners used to haul bucketfuls of bat crap out of Bracken Cave through this mine shaft. Going into a bat cave, for any reason, was and still is a ridiculously dirty and dangerous, disgusting job. Let's do it.
No one here really harvests bat guano anymore, but today, Bracken Cave, 60 miles outside of Austin, Texas, is the place to be if you're a bat biologist like Jim Kennedy.
Well, whenever I see a respirator and a hard hat, I get a little nervous, and I guess with good reason. Jim, we're in front of Bracken Cave. If I listen very carefully, there's some chirping.
Yeah, you hear a real high-pitched chittery noise.
Yeah.
That's the bats.
And how many bats are in there?
Well, right now there's probably close to 40 million.
40 million?
Yes, we have lots of bats. In fact, this is the largest known concentration of warm-blooded animals anywhere on the planet.
Why do I have to wear this in there?
If you don't, you're gonna die. Put it pretty bluntly.
Good tip.
Not only is it hot and humid in the cave, but there's very high levels of carbon dioxide, and what's worse is the ammonia. On the floor of the cave, there's a kind of beetle called a dermestid beetle, which is a flesh-eating beetle. And when these beetles are feeding off of the guano and other things, they're producing a lot of ammonia as a byproduct. And it gets really high levels. If we didn't have the respirators, your eyes would burn, your throat and lungs would burn, you would soon pass out and be stripped to the bone by all those beetles.
I have a gray t-shirt and you have a fancy crimson and blue nylon treated rubber bat suit.
Pretty spiffy.
Yeah, one of us didn't get the memo. Let's go batting.
Jim's primary mission is to monitor the bats and their living conditions to ensure that the population is not being threatened by outside forces. Several times a year, Jim must venture into Bracken Cave to inspect the roost and chart any variations in temperature.
You feeling the rain yet?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they're pissing all over me.
Hey, Mike, come here. I want to show you something. Remember what the temperature I told you was in the cave normally when the bats aren't here?
Like 68?
About 68. This is an infrared thermometer. Whenever a beam goes out and hits it, it comes back and it tells us the temperature. The floor right now, 86 degrees. Let's shoot up the ceiling. You know, hot air rises. Let's see what we got up here. Might be a little hard because all the bats flying around. About 90 degrees. No wonder we're sweating. All right, I'm gonna show you something here.
All right.
Jim also gets hands-on with the bats, checking them for parasites and signs of disease.
How much do they eat?
They're eating at least their body weight every night.
And that's why we're standing in.
Tons of guano. The bats, each night, this colony alone is eating over 200 tons of insects.
That's amazing.
That's a lot of byproduct, yeah.
So tell me what's going on here, Jim.
Well, you see on the surface lots of fresher bat droppings. They're not all broken down into little dust like we were seeing before. There actually are pellets now. We also see the remains of the bats that didn't make it. You got a lot of young bats that on their first flight, you know, they've never flown before, they're dropping out, and a lot of them just crash and burn. We also get some older bats, some adults and so on, as they get older, and some of them eventually die in here as well. And these bugs here on the floor, these are the dermestid beetles and their larvae, they're taking advantage of that.
It's incredible. It's like the whole floor is moving.
Yeah,